With the COVID-19 vaccine being approved for everyone 12 and up, I'm sure you have a lot of questions. I know I do. How does it work? Is it safe? I knew just the person who would answer these and many more questions. Dr. Jeremy Friedman is the Associate Pediatrician-in-Chief at SickKids. Hi, Dr. Friedman.
Hi, Melissa.
So the first question I have for you is, how does the COVID-19 vaccine work?
So, like other vaccines, the COVID-19 mRNA vaccines, which are currently known by the companies who produce them, so you've probably heard of Pfizer and Moderna, they work by teaching your body how to recognize a small piece of the COVID-19 virus. Once your immune cells have learned how to recognize the virus, they're ready to fight off the COVID-19 virus if you get infected at a later stage.
Why do I have to get two COVID-19 vaccines instead of just one?
So the first shot helps the immune system recognize the virus, and the second shot strengthens the immune response. So the first shot will give you some protection, but if you really want to be properly protected, then you must get the second shot as well.
How can we be sure that the vaccine is safe? It seemed like it got approved really fast.
Yeah, it does seem quick, but the mRNA technology, which is how the vaccine is produced, has actually been around for decades. Scientists have been working with this technology to create vaccines that we use all the time, such as the flu virus or the rabies virus vaccine, even the Zika virus vaccine. All of the processes that are normally followed to ensure safety and efficacy in terms of clinical trials, including in kids 12 to 18, they were all done very appropriately. And interestingly, even kids under the age of 12, there are now trials looking at them, and we'll probably get those results later in the year. So I think it seems quick, but partly because everybody in the world's working on it at the same time. And there is so much COVID-19 out there that it is making it easier for scientists and doctors to work out just how effective and safe the current vaccines are.
Can the COVID-19 vaccine give me a coronavirus infection?
No. So we're absolutely sure that the vaccine cannot make you sick with COVID-19. None of the COVID-19 vaccines that we're using in Canada contain any of the live virus, which means that you cannot actually get the virus from the shot.
Do I need my parents' permission to get the vaccine, or do they need to come with me?
So I think it's important to discuss the vaccine with your parent or your caregiver. And when you come and get the vaccine, the person who's giving it to you will explain to you all the risks and the benefits and give you a chance to ask questions. And as long as you're able to understand the risks and benefits, then you actually don't need consent from a parent or caregiver. You can consent yourself. But your parent or caregiver certainly can come along with you to get the vaccine if you feel more comfortable with that.
How will I feel after I get the vaccine?
Some people do experience some mild side effects from the vaccine for a few hours to a few days after getting it. You may have a little bit of a sore arm, maybe a mild headache, maybe some aches and pains, maybe feel a little bit tired, or even have a low-grade fever. But many people actually don't experience any side effects at all. If you don't develop any symptoms, though, it doesn't mean that the vaccine's not working. It just means that everybody reacts a little bit differently. And then finally, I'd say an allergic or anaphylactic reaction to the vaccine is incredibly rare, but everybody's asked to wait for about 15 minutes after getting the vaccine just to make sure that you're absolutely fine.
All right, so do these current vaccines work against the variant strains of COVID-19?
Now that the COVID-19 virus has been around for a while, it's had a chance to sort of morph and mutate into a whole lot of different strains or types of the virus. And currently, there are several variant strains circulating in different parts of the world, and vaccine experts are continuing to conduct trials to see how effective the current vaccines are against these variants of concern. I'm quite relieved and happy to say that certainly at this point, it appears that the vaccines that we have are effective against the variants of concern that are out there at the current time.
That's good to hear. Is there any reason why I should wait to get my COVID vaccine?
If you've had any COVID-19 symptoms, then you have to wait until you're feeling completely better. If you've been in contact with anybody who's tested positive for COVID, then you have to wait until you're out of isolation or out of quarantine. And finally, if just by chance you've had any routine regular immunizations, you have to wait about 2 weeks from that before. Otherwise, I would say as soon as you can, you should go and get it.
That's good to know. Is there any impact on future fertility and puberty by getting the COVID-19 vaccine?
So there is no data and no research to suggest that the COVID-19 virus vaccine will have any impact either on puberty or fertility or reproductive health at all.
Is there anything else that I should know about the vaccine?
The one thing I'd say is a lot of people are kind of scared of getting a needle, and quite honestly, it's not my favorite thing either. What I would say is this is a very small needle, and certainly my experience of it was probably the least painful needle I've ever had in my life. So I don't want people to be too worried about that aspect. And if you are anxious, then just let the team know when you're getting your shot, and they have lots of strategies and things in place that can make the whole process much easier for you. The other thing I'd say is people often ask me, you know, are you confident that this vaccine is appropriate for young people? And part of my answer to them is I have an 18-year-old and a 20-year-old. And the minute that we heard that the vaccine was available in that age group, I got them to go online and find the first pop-up clinic that was vaccinating people of their age and get in line right away to get their shot. So I think that says something. I mean, I've been at SickKids for the last year, and even though we all know that most kids do really well with COVID and don't get terribly sick, we certainly have had children of all ages having to be admitted to hospital, some of them getting quite sick with COVID. It's rare, but it can happen. So I think it's just a fantastic thing that in such a short period of time, we've got something that actually can protect everyone, including kids, from getting the COVID infection.
Great, thank you.
You're very welcome, Melissa.